Hello and welcome to A Word from the Wise, the Solwise podcast. We come to you at the end of each month and we talk about all things related to the world of Wi-Fi and the internet. We discuss new products and things going on within the industry, and we give advice on how to get the best out of the products that we sell. If you're just listening to us, you can head over to YouTube or Spotify to see the video version of this podcast. And with that being said, please enjoy today's podcast. Hello, welcome to A Word from the Wise, a Solwise podcast. This time we're going to talk about the InHand Networks range of 4G and 5G routers. They are a new brand to us. We started talking to them back end of last summer and finally got stock the early January 2025. There's a nice little range of industrial routers, personal routers and enterprise routers. And we'll go through all of those and introduce you to what we've got. So, shall we start with the one in the middle? Because I think that's the most interesting one, because we don't do anything like that, do we?
No. So, that's the CR202. And so, obviously, with these being mobile routers, you can think of them as alternatives to our current Teltonika range. The CR202 doesn't have an exact equivalent, but it is a Cat6 router, which means it can get the kind of equivalent speed you might get out of a RUT 260 or RUT 361, about 300 megabits. It can do carrier aggregation. And it's kind of a router that's designed to be portable. So we've obviously got a lot of people that would like to use these in their camper vans and motorhomes, and it's kind of well suited for that. It comes with a mount that allows it to be surface mounted, and it can be powered by battery. It comes with a battery, with an 8-hour battery life.
It's all built in, isn't it?
Yeah.
Although, interestingly, you say 8 hours. The chap from ExploreVan, when he reviewed it, we'll put a link to his video in the comments below, he got 12 hours out of it.
Mm.
That's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
So if it's battery powered, can you still plug it in, say, by the power? Oh, it's a USB there, is it?
Yeah.
So but you could power it straight from that as
it
well.
It can still be powered straight from that, which a lot of the times it will be. And whilst it's powered, it's charging its battery.
Okay.
So if you were to take out one about, you can do.
And it has Ethernet ports. Does it do PoE, so you could power it over Ethernet?
No, it doesn't do PoE. No. It's just got its little USB 5-volt DC power.
Yeah.
And then the battery.
Yeah. So it's a good one. It's a bit like the MiFi devices that people say to festivals and stuff like that, isn't it? Although more interestingly, this one over a MiFi device has got the external antenna ports, hasn't it?
Mm. And I think for its price range, the fact that it's a Cat6 router, which means it can do faster speeds than a lot of the Cat4 routers that we do.
Yeah.
I think it's quite good value.
Yeah. It's been an interesting product, and one that we felt would be a really good addition to the range. And interestingly, after the review came out from ExploreVan, sales were pretty good on that one.
Mm.
So it'll be interesting to see what customers have to say when they get it. Should be good. The other one that Mike from ExploreVan has reviewed is the FWA02, the enterprise one, which whilst it is an enterprise level router, so you'd think it was going to go into businesses and so on, he really liked that for the van life people. I suppose the nearest we've got to that is the Teltonika RUTX50 would be a similar,
I think,
sort of thing.
For the FWA02, it would probably be the RUT C50,
right, okay.
Because it's got the same kind of high-end 5G speeds,
yeah,
about 3 to 4 gigabits mobile speeds.
Yeah.
But then on the Wi-Fi side, it's actually Wi-Fi 6, like the RUT C50. So
yeah,
it's got the best kind of Wi-Fi coverage that you can really expect from it in terms of wireless speeds. So for anyone, whether it's an enterprise setting or it's domestic household, or if they're traveling and they just want the best possible mobile speeds they can get from their network, then I think it's great for that, because it's got really powerful Wi-Fi 6.
And he was really keen on the speeds on it, wasn't he? Very keen.
The other thing that would be interesting to know is it actually has six antenna ports.
Mm.
So we don't have an antenna that would fit that, do we?
No, you would use probably ideally a 4x4 antenna and a 2x2 or a 4x4 and two singles. You can experiment with what works best for your, I suppose, mounting possibilities.
Could you use a 4x4 for the 5G and then another 2x2 for 5G as well?
Yeah, that's sort of what I'm saying is it's all mobile antennas, and it's just about the kind of the combination of 4x4, 2x2 or single that works best for how you want to have it set up. Because maybe you've got room to have a bunch of different antennas, maybe you've got limited space. You can have some, maybe just keep some of the indoor aerials that come with, see how they go.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's quite
flexible.
Quite up to how you want to do it.
It takes us on then to the industrial one. So these are all metal. Got the external antenna ports. They've got the
RS232 and 485 and the input output things, just to make them compatible with sensors and industrial equipment, that kind of thing.
Yeah. There's quite a nice range of those as well, with the extra antenna ports, the extra Ethernet ports and so on.
Yeah. And they do, part of the reason they have those facilities on them is they do edge computing. So there'll be cases where they're being connected to equipment that tracks data, sensors, monitoring equipment, that kind of thing. And it can handle it all internally in the router before the data has to go out anywhere. So it can do kind of quite complicated tasks very quickly without slowing down the rest of the network, slowing down a cloud network. And they're Cat4 devices, I believe. So you can think of them as sort of equivalents to the RUTs 200, maybe the RUT 956, because of their machine-to-machine qualities.
Dual SIM, though, so they do have an edge there.
Yeah, like the RUT 956, yeah.
Of course, yeah. Just looking at the other extra things that they might do. The other thing I did want to mention is some of them, as the Teltonic ones do too as well, is that they are come with the DIN rail mounts already attached. So if anyone's watching, the DIN mounts are here.
Yeah, they consider how people are going to want to be mounting them, and they come with that already.
Yeah, well, and that's really is the sort of thing, is that what they're made of, their IP rating and all of that is what makes it really an industrial used type router, isn't
it? And even like some of the more industrial type Teltonic routers are still perfectly fine to use in just normal environments. They're still very good, obviously very dependable, rugged 4G routers in their own right if you just wanted to use them in your house or camper van.
Well, to be fair, if you're using them in a camper van or a motorhome, you might want something that's a bit more rugged. If you think if you're going to drive from Yorkshire to Morocco, you're going to want something that's a bit sturdy over the road surfaces and out in the heat and then maybe in the cold, depending on where you're going. So having something that is a bit more sturdy, like these are and the Teltonica ones, and it's definitely worth a consideration, and maybe paying that bit more really is getting what you pay for, isn't it? So I read that there are two different remote management systems with in-hand products. So how does that work? Is that an enterprise one and an industrial one, or how does that work?
Basically, they have one which is called InCloud, which is, well, they're all cloud platforms, but InCloud is the one used by the FWA02 of the ones that we do. And that's their kind of enterprise level one for standard, just remote tooling about with them. And then there is InHand Device Manager, which is their other one that's more designed for the industrial kind of ones they do, the IR302s and so on, which just gives you a bit more to play with when it comes to monitoring them for the kind of things you might be monitoring.
Is there a cloud management system for the
that one also uses one? Device Manager. Yeah,
that's the same as these industrial ones, right? Okay. that's quite useful, isn't it? We've found that remote management with regards to the Teltonika ones over the years has been quite good. Do you happen to know, is there licensing with the InHand ones?
There's licensing for InCloud, similar to the licenses you use for the Teltonika RMS.
Right.
For device manager, there's no licensing, really.
No, so that is just a way of looking after it. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you very much. So that brings us to the end. This is a short but sweet, really, video introducing the InHand products to the Solwise range. We'll do some more in-depth videos with each of the routers and the gateways that we also have. Definitely would like to direct you to the Explore Van videos for the CR202 and the FWA02, because Mike's done a really good job of those. So that's definitely worth having a look at. And we will be back soon with some in-depth looks at each of them. Mm-hmm. And we'll see you next time. Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching or listening, whichever you chose to do. If you have any podcast ideas for future episodes, please leave us a comment in the section below, or even drop us an email to sales@solwise.co.uk. If you've got any specific questions, again, you can pop us an email across. Don't forget to give us a like if you've enjoyed this podcast, and remember to subscribe so you never miss when we upload. Thanks for joining us, and we will see you next month.